I want to talk about being insecure. You said that you felt like you isolated yourself.
Yes, I thought that I had dealt with it. You know, losing your hair is hard. And then losing your eyebrows and your eyelashes and everything else, I think that's worse than the hair. Like, I would rather be bald and still have eyelashes and eyebrows, because as you know, these are not real. So I thought, like, okay, you know, I shaved my head and I lost all the, you know, anything that was left there from chemo, I lost it. And you know, women, some of our validation comes from the fact that men find us attractive.
Yeah.
There was, like, nothing. I mean, literally, I was invisible. I remember when I first lost my hair and I went out with my mom to some store, and I saw a guy, like, literally avoid, like, looked and then avoided, like, as if my cancer could, you know, jump to him. Or it was sort of, you know, like a, oh God, because, you know, the no eyebrows and the no eyelashes is, I think
did you, where you had a scarf on?
And I had a bandana on, yeah, but, you know, this was still
what it
was. And I think all of a sudden it hit me. I got very insecure. I got very like, oh my God, I'm so not who I used to be. And then that kind of put me in a weird spot where I was looking at my husband thinking, he didn't marry this. Like, this is not who he married. You know, he married the girl with, like, the long, you know, beautiful dark hair.
It's so interesting, because hair sounds like such a stupid,
sounds
bullshit
so vain,
thing.
Right?
But it is so... It is such an attachment for any woman.
God,
like,
it's
it is
tied
like
to, like, who
everything
you
are is your
feminine
hair.
Yes. And I think what's beautiful and hard and interesting about cancer is that it tears you down and builds you, and tears you down and builds you, and it remakes you so many different times. So the person that I thought I was supposed to be, or was going to be, or who I thought I was 6 months ago, is now somebody completely different. And I realized, wow, I really thought that I was so brave and so courageous this entire time, and really I was just hiding. And I was, don't cry.
Well, I mean, all right, hold on a second. Fuck.
Don't
hold
cry.
On. I won't. Okay.
So this was very hard and not humbling, because I've already been humbled by cancer, but, like, it was hard, and just this sense of rethinking sort of who you are and how you come to terms with who you are now and accepting it, and then looking at your husband and thinking, like, dude, I'm so sorry.
When you talk about Kurt, you told me, like, you told me one time that you didn't think he would show up for you in this way. Did you think somebody wouldn't stick around for you?
Yeah, I mean, I don't think it was just... You know, I don't think it was Kurt specifically. I think it was me and sort of my baggage, my life, you know, acting since I was 10, being in a business that's very hard on people, particularly on women. And I don't think I trusted men completely. Mm-hmm. I also didn't trust women, you know, I just didn't trust.
Anybody, just trust
yeah.
at all.
You know, it's so funny, because a lot of people have looked at him and said, wow, you really stepped up, and he's like, That's it's like you're indicating that I wasn't there to begin with. And he gets very offended, and I totally understand where he's coming from, but I think that somebody can be doing this, right? Like, amazing. They're on this really high pedestal, but something tragic can happen and some people bail. I have girlfriends who got cancer and their husbands literally left them over it. And sure, those people are obviously not good people, but it happens all the time. But Kurt, he took his dedication and his love for me, and he took it to a whole other level. You know, he has a career, and we have to earn money, and I'm not working because of this. And he still sort of, the most important thing was, I cannot work when my wife has chemo. And it's, here's the dates. And by the way, she gets really sick, so I have to block out these days. And when I had surgery, it was like he blocked out so much time. I mean, so much time for it, and was active and involved. I you know, I couldn't have gotten through this without him. That I know.
There are so many people that don't step up to the plate.
Yes, and men and women.
That can't deal with it. And it's not because they're bad. It's because they're ill-equipped. People can't deal with the notion of the thought of losing you. Like, that must be a horrible thing that he's had to contemplate.
Or some people just don't want to go through the process.
Right.
You know,
yeah,
look,
yeah.
It's hard. It's
fucking
draining.
Pain in the ass.
Yeah.
Right.
It's, you're no longer, you know, dressing up to go to, like, the newest hip spot for dinner. It's not that. You're holding somebody's, you know, hair until it's all out. And then you've got a washcloth next to them. And it's all, you know, you're watching them throw up every single second. And you're cleaning up after them. And you're literally, like, carrying them and putting them in a car and taking them to a doctor's office and, you know, picking them up. And, you know, I mean, there were days when I couldn't walk. I physically couldn't walk. I couldn't eat. And I just remember him the first time after the first chemo session, and I was so sick, and it was really bad, and I was getting dehydrated, and no water, there was, like, nothing. And he just sat on the edge of the bed, and he's like, you have to, like, fight this, you have to, I can't lose you, you have to fight. And I was like, oh my God. I mean, you know, like, that's somebody who... You want that person by your side.
Yeah,
everyone. Every second,
that's
right?
Like every woman's dream is to have that person, yeah. Man that loves you like that.
Yes.
Like your father loves
and
you.
And then, you know, surprisingly, I lost friends over cancer.
Like,
so
why? What do you mean, though?
I mean, like, people who didn't show up. People who definitely went, no. Nope.
You're
just not fun anymore. You're sick. You're not drinking, and you're talking about cancer. And I don't want to hear you talk about cancer. I want to talk about me. And I lost friends, like friends that I've had for a really long time, like heartbreaking, almost like losing, like a marriage ending. I mean, it was very heartbreaking. And at the same time, that's when I go, God, cancer is a godsend in a lot of ways, because boy, did it clean house in my life.
What are some of the moments that you've had with your mom since this happened?
Oh, so many. I mean, you know, there wasn't one moment that she wasn't there.
And it's hard to see your mom see you. Like, my biggest fear in life would be for my mom to see me, like, sick.
Yeah, I mean, look, I always say, because of course your mother goes, well, I wish it was, you know, me instead. And I, with the moment she said that to me, I went, absolutely not, because I can get through it.
Mm-hmm.
Like,
tough.
I know, yeah. I can get through it, and I would take on this disease 10 more times to avoid a family member, my husband or my mother getting it. I would 100%, I would fight this nonstop.
Do you think that you're tougher now than you've ever been?
No, I think I'm way more vulnerable. I think I'm more.
But tough in the means of.
Of being able to face stuff?
Of being able to keep getting up and going, yep, let's go. I've got a good attitude about this. That's tough.
Yeah.
That's what I mean by being tough.
But I think, I guess for me, I've always viewed myself as tough my entire life and having a lot of tenacity. You know, I've been knocked down so many times in my life by all sorts of things, not just, you know, in my career, but, you know, losing my father was, I didn't think I would ever recover from losing my dad. My dad was my best friend. My dad was like my world. You know, he was and still remains in a way everything to me. So losing him, I was positive I was, you know, never gonna recover from that, and I did. So I guess I don't look at myself and go, oh, I've gotten so much tougher. What I look at and say to myself is, wow, like I don't feel like I have to hide behind a tough exterior anymore. Like, I don't feel like I have to put on this tough girl front.
Right.
In order for people to either respond to me or to protect myself anymore. Now I'm like, no, I'll cry with you. And, you know, maybe there's some people that think it's ridiculous that I cry at the drop of a dime now, but that's me. And
did you say you didn't cry before?
No, I think I held it in really well. I mean, I think nobody really saw that vulnerable side. And now it's like, I have no outside shell at this point. What you see is everything that's going on. And I'm ridiculously transparent. And I think that for somebody like me, it can be a little scary, but it's a good thing.
Yeah,
you know,
I think,
like,
it's great.
I like it. I like the change. There's a lot of bad things about cancer, obviously, but there's also so much good. Like, it's changed my life in a lot of ways that I will forever be thankful for.
I think so.
Yeah.
Since you got to the end of that video, I'm going to show you something that's going to blow your mind. I realize that I've never walked up this staircase on my set, and I don't know what's behind this door at the top, so we're just going to find out together. And
hey guys, hit the subscribe button right now for more videos.